This is Teddy D, and everybody's got a story. So thank you for listening to another Why Not podcast. And I'm the host, so I'm the constant on this show. So any show that you've heard, I've been on there, you know, some more than others. And to tell you the secret about producing a show like this, you can take out and leave in whatever it is that you want, good or bad. And in a way, you control the spin, you know, on how you want people to hear you. So there's not a lot of raw interactions unless you want it to be. So this is going to be different for me, but I wanted to do this to start off what hopefully is a really cool segment for the show. My story isn't of a specific time, but it is about the effect that one person has had in my life. I am currently producing this show, and by the time that you hear this, I think one or two will be out, and I've been working on them for a while now. But I'm on the mic today with a heavy heart because waterworks already started. Because one of my closest friends, Eric Smith, his mother passed away, Miss Mary Smith. And let me tell you, I love Miss Mary. Love Miss Mary for a lot of reasons. And I wanted to take this time just to dedicate a couple of minutes to eulogize somebody who made a really big impact on my life. So Eric and I were in a singing group called Focus, along with Ben, Chris, and Titus. One of which you've heard on the show, the other two hopefully soon you'll hear on the show. And we were good. It was R&B singing group. We all went to the same high school, so it made it easier to practice. But, you know, we were good. And a lot of times we would need a place to rehearse, or we would need a place to just crash for the night because, you know, whatever reason. And a lot of times it would end up being over Eric's house or my house. And Eric lived, of course, with his mom, Miss Mary. And Miss Mary, Eric's mixed, and Miss Mary was this beautiful spirit of maybe five foot tall white woman with blonde hair that cussed like a sailor. But when I say she loved us, man, like she genuinely loved us. Eric and I have been friends since we played ball together at Barrytown's basketball league when we were in like eighth grade or something. And but I really got closer to him when I went to Eastern High School my junior year. And that's the year that we started Focus with the three other guys I mentioned. So I spent a lot of time over there, even when we weren't rehearsing, just because that was my friend. And I just got to know Miss Mary, you know, and I mentioned that on a podcast you can sound as polished as you want to, because, you know, I mean, it may not come across in the shows, but I was pretty bad. Well, I'm not gonna say bad. Like I got in trouble in high school a lot. Silly stuff, you know, not doing my work, you know, just silly stuff. But the family that I come from is full of academics, you know, like everyone, like it's my two parents and my older sister, and everybody has an advanced degree except for me, which, you know, I still don't have a 4-year degree. But I say that because they're high achievers, and a lot was always expected of me. So needless to say, I disappointed them a lot. It just kind of turned out that way. And they always loved me, you know, like it wasn't that type of thing. It's not a woe is me, but like a lot of times as a teenager specifically, and even as a young man in my 20s, my confidence was very shaken. very low about where I was academically and by default socially because of it. So I didn't have a lot of advocates because my family wasn't really advocating for, you know, me being a good person. Because to them, I'm like, you know, like a cool guy, but the kid that doesn't apply himself, you know what I'm saying? So I really got into music. I really got into just, you know, volunteering. I really got into the church. So, like, I was doing good things. But, you know, in the back of my mind, I'm just like, man, I know I could be doing more, but I don't know if I can. And, you know, Miss Mary, to me, I got news. I got the news. Eric called me the other night when she passed away. And the job I work now, I have to get up at 4 a.m. Every day and go in. So I go to bed really early. So I was laying down when Eric called me at 10 p.m. And, you know, it didn't register something was wrong when he called, but he's just like, hey, just to let you know, mom passed away. And it just knocked a pause in me. It knocked a pause in me because I called a couple of times the week before to check on her, and I knew she was in the hospital, and I usually always went to see her. I brought her a balloon, you know, a gift, and gave her a kiss and let her know that I loved her. But this time I just hadn't made her around. You know, I have a new son. You know, I just got busy. So I didn't get a chance to see her before she passed away. But when Eric called me, it didn't really register to me what he was saying. You know, I told him I'm sorry. I checked with him, made sure he was all right. And, you know, that was it. So my wife and I were about to go to sleep, but she heard what happened. And, you know, she didn't really know. I don't think the reverence that I have for Miss Mary, but, you know, she kind of figured it out. So here I am. I'm kind of laid up in bed about an hour later. She's asleep. And, you know, I was just thinking about her. You know, and I prayed and I thank God for her. And of course I pray for Eric and Sean, who she was watching after too. And, man, I started crying like I am now. And, my wife heard me, and I was trying to do the quiet cry if anybody's done that before, but she heard me. So, you know, what do you do? And, she's like, why are you crying? Talk to me. What's going on? And without even thinking, I explained to her that, you know, Miss Mary, she always saw the good in me. She always saw the good in me. And I never got a chance to tell her thank you for that. But I think she knew how much I loved her and appreciated her. So, one of the things that we bonded on was our love of music. So every time we performed as a group, Focus, she would come out and she would be there, and she would always end up crying. I'm just like, I mean, come on, Miss Mary, we're singing love songs to like young girls. Why are you crying? You know, like, what are you doing? But she saw, I think, in our group, a collection of misfits who got it together and were doing something positive. And that's what our life is all about. So, you know, I just wanted to say thank you publicly. Thank you to Miss Mary, and thank you to Eric for sharing her with us. And we love you. And I figured there was no other way to go out. But a song that we talked about a lot, Sam Cooke. And there it is. Thank you.
Telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. Help me, please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Lord, there have been times that I thought I couldn't last for long. But I know a change gonna come.